almost surreal. A couple of people have referred to it looking almost like a dinosaur.
What was the 140-year-old Bartonsville covered bridge lay twisted hundreds of feet from where it once stood. The floodwaters from Tropical Storm Irene took the 170-foot-long bridge away, literally. A viewer was rolling as the water picked up the bridge, sweeping it down the Williams River.
Surprisingly, a lot of the bridge was still intact, or at least in big pieces, and it was just unbelievable.
Now, a year later, the site looks very different. The water in the Williams is low, and above it, a bridge connecting Rockingham to Lower Bartonsville is back, but it's not permanent. New abutments with steel pilings down to the bedrock hold this temporary one-lane structure. The new covered bridge will look just like the old one, but will be slightly longer and stronger. Engineers hope it will hold up to Irene-like events in the years to come.
This is very utilitarian. It does what it's supposed to do, but it's nowhere near what we had before and what we intend to have in the future.
Both sides of the Williams River are connected once again with this temporary span. The new Bartonsville covered bridge will take this one's place, hopefully, in February. It's a similar story about 30 miles north in Queechy, where they hope their new covered bridge will be installed in December.
They're hard at work in Queechy. The old covered bridge is gone, deemed unsafe after Irene's waters battered it for hours on end.
The water actually got to the street level, to Queechy Main Street street level, which essentially was surrounding the bridge on either side.
Down the street at the Simon Pierce Mill, they're ready to be connected once again.
Now that the bridge has been removed, again, it's about communicating that it's about progress and that we're going to get this brand new bridge. It's going to be even better.
They have a front row view as workers prepare the abutments for the new, longer and wider Queechy Bridge. The new bridge is expected to be about 18 feet longer, 2 feet wider, and several inches higher. People here hope it will again bring visitors to Queechy Village from all directions.
Because they know what we've been through, they know what the state's been through, and now that the bridge is gone and the new one's coming, it's all about moving forward.
Moving forward after a year of rebuilding and reconnecting all across the state. In Queechy, Vermont, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5.